Hello, everybody. It is I, BigAl, once again. Now, before we start this rant, the last rant of 2012, isn't that fucking crazy? I guess you can call this a bit of a preview. Now, when I did the Wreck-It Ralph review, I didn't have any fucking actual Ralph shirts or anything. I had the overalls, but no Ralph shirts. Now, I actually have one. Ripped the sleeves and everything, got an actual green undershirt. I guess you can say this is a preview of what's to come at OhioCon 2013. But anyway, yes, I moved the camera. But anyway, this has been a rant I've been wanting to do for a long-ass fucking time. Back in fucking the 2006/2007 era of when I started out on YouTube. And I don't know why I put it off for so long, but I guess it's now time to talk about it. We're going to talk about Kidz Bop. I just don't understand the point of Kidz Bop. I mean, you have all these popular songs. Why would you ever let overprivileged, tone-deaf little shits ruin them? You know, if the songs are good to begin with, why can't you just, you know, let the kids listen to them as they are? Oh, wait, I know, because half the things that they sing are fucking terrible for kids. They have to edit the shit out of them in order for kids to sing them in the first place. And that kind of defeats the purpose of that, don't you think? This is going to be a point that I repeat over and over again, and I think, and it's because it's one of the biggest, one of my biggest reasons for hating Kidz Bop. Many of the songs that they have on the Kidz Bop CDs have to be edited. They have to be shortened. They have to be fucked with and cut and all this other shit happening to them. Because either A, the biggest reason is because the lyrics themselves in the original song are not suitable for kids. So it begs the question, if you have to edit the song just for kids to sing it in the first place, then you shouldn't let them sing it, period. You see where I'm coming from? If you have to edit a song because the lyrics aren't up to snuff for an audience of children, just so that children can sing it, then maybe they shouldn't even be listening to it or singing it in the first fucking place. And I think the best example of this is LMFAO's song, Party Rock Anthem. Now, we're going to take a look at the lyrics very quick, okay? Okay. The main lyrics, not Party Rock is in the house tonight, the actual lyrics. In the club, party rock, looking for your girl, she on my jock. Non-stop when we in the spot, booty moving weight like she on the block. Wear the drink, I gots to know, tight jeans tattoo, cause I'm rock and roll. Half black, half white, domino, give me money, opa-dough. Yo, I'm running through these hoes like Drano. I got that devilish flow, rock and roll, no halo. We party rock, yeah, that's the crew that I'm reppin'. On the rise to the top, no leader or Zeppelin, hey. Set up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We gettin' money, don't be nan now, stop, hatin' is bad. One more shot for us, another one. Please fill up my cup, don't mess around. We just want to see you shake it now. Now you want to be, you're naked now. And that's pretty much it for the main lyrics of Party Rock Anthem. You see what the problem is? Basically, when you get right down to it, the song, and I'm not even trying to be a soccer mom here, just hear me out. The song is about going to the dance floor, drinking like crazy, and throwing money at women so that they'll fuck you. That's pretty much what they're saying. And Kidz Bop somehow was able to put that song on their CD. Keep in mind, this is LMFAO, where another one of their songs is called I'm Sexy and I Know It, where the music video for that, I know I do this a lot, I like hand movements, where the music video for I'm Sexy and I Know It features the singers from LMFAO and Banana Hammocks waving their dick in front of the camera. And yet, Kidz Bop somehow thinks that's kid-friendly. I don't know. So let me get to my main point. I read off every single main lyric of Party Rock Anthem from LMFAO. Now, how did Kidz Bop handle this? Now, I'll tell you how they handled it. They didn't. They couldn't sing the whole song. And I'm not talking about they just, you know, they edited a portion or they cut out a portion. No. This song is so fucking terrible for kids. Kidz Bop couldn't even cover it. They don't cover the main song. They cover the chorus. Party Rock is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time. And we're going to make you lose your mind. Everybody just have a good time. That's all they sing. That is literally all they sing in the Kidz Bop version. Over and over. The song is like half as long as the actual song. They didn't do a cover of LMFAO's Party Rock Anthem. They did a cover of the chorus of LMFAO's Party Rock Anthem. And it's really funny when they do covers of Lady Gaga songs, because if you look at Lady Gaga songs, half of them are about fucking. Literally fucking. You know, this beat is sick. I want to take you right on your disco stick. I think we all know what the hell she's talking about. And Telephone is about, you know, drinking at the club and getting bad phone reception. Of course, she's going to say, oh, it's about the struggles of gay marriage. No, it's not, sweetheart. It's not. And I might as well put this out right now. I don't hate Lady Gaga. It's weird coming from me, considering all the videos considering the videos that I have made about her. But I've grown to like her a little bit. You know, as shitty as some of her songs are, they're actually really catchy. But like I said, it's really funny when Kidz Bop covers her songs because of the subtext of all of her songs. Like, Judas is basically Stockholm Syndrome the musical. You know, tell me that isn't. I mean, I know there's obviously religious subtext there, but tell me it isn't. Oh, my boyfriend beats the shit out of me, but I still love him. And then we come to the reason, probably the main reason why I've decided to finally get it done with this rant. In the upcoming Kidz Bop 23, yes, they've actually managed to shell out 23 goddamn CDs of this shit. They're covering Gangnam Style. Now, say what you want about Gangnam Style. I know I know some people who hate it. I know some people who love it. I know some people who loved it at first, but then, much like Rick Roll and Caramel Dancing and every other popular internet meme song of all time, it overstayed its welcome. And personally, I love the song. I think it's catchy as hell. I think it like Caramel Dancing, will stick around conventions for a long time. But it's not the first time that a foreign song has got our attention on American radio. Don't forget the way back when there was that one song called Sukiyaki from Japan. We don't even know the real name of it. We just called it Sukiyaki, you know. Do 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 do. And then there was that one song, 99 Luft Balloons. Not to mention every single goddamn album that Rammstein has released. And then we just have Psy from South Korea with his song Gangnam Style, which became an overnight sensation, a flash in the pan, if you will. And much like every other popular song, it's bound to have someone cover it, and unfortunately, they did. By people who weren't Korean and were white as white can fucking be. It was, of course, covered by the Glee Club, which, I'm gonna be honest, I fucking hate that show. Glee is stupid as all hell. All their covers suck. And I think it's hilarious that they covered Gangnam Style because they have a Japanese woman singing it, which you might think, well, it's close enough. But when you really think about it, when you really think about how Japan and Korea have a very uneasy relationship, it's actually kind of a fucking insult to have a Japanese person sing a Korean pop song. You know, I'm not trying to be a weeaboo or anything, but that's how it gets viewed. You know, I'm telling the truth about that. That's how it usually gets viewed. Like, that's how it usually gets viewed. But anyway, I'd rather listen to their version of Gangnam Style over and over again than ever listen to Kidz Bop's. That's right, folks. Kidz Bop is covering Gangnam Style. You may now arm your shotguns and blow your fucking brains out. And I'm going to play for you a sample of it. This is, well, something. Here it is. Opa Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. So, besides the fact that Gangnam Style is being sung by tone-deaf little shits who probably have never read or heard anything Korean in their fucking lives, you may notice that the lyrics, "Hey, sexy lady," have been changed to "Hey, hey lady," which, of course, doesn't make any fucking sense. And now it goes right back to what I said about LMFAO. When you look at the music video for Gangnam Style, it's clearly not for children. It's Psy, you know, dancing provocatively and dancing with women, very scantily clad women. And there are zoom-ups from the camera to women's asses bending over. Yes, I'm pretty sure I would love to have my 3-year-old niece watch that. Clearly this song is for children. It's just, I'm not even trying to be like a fucking soccer mom about this. It's just common sense. If it's not meant for children to begin with, then what is the point of editing it so it is? Clearly it's not for children. You know, if you're gonna change one little word so that kids could sing it, they might as well not sing it at all. I mean, Katy Perry's Last Friday Night, you know, "I feel sexy and free," that's been changed to "I feel happy and free." It doesn't make any fucking sense. You know, Kidz Bop, I just don't know why. Why does this even exist? And of course, people are gonna bring up this clip.
"We've got to have money."
Because, you know, that's the most obvious fucking reason, right? You know, "We've got to have money." But it just doesn't make any sense. Who is buying these? Who in their right fucking mind looks at these on the shelf and go, "Oh my god, I gotta have me some Kidz Bop for my fucking rave party." But yeah, that's all I gotta say about Kidz Bop. Fuck Kidz Bop. They not only do they ruin good songs that never needed this revolting treatment to begin with, they lack common sense. Like, you're taking songs about looking for women to fuck on the dance floor and you're somehow making kids sing it. You know, what are you gonna do? That they're just gonna listen to that version? No, they're gonna find the real song and they're gonna listen to it and they're gonna end up getting fucked in the head. Well, maybe not to that extent, but you get what I mean. You're trying to shelter the kids from the fucking, you know, "I'm running through these holes like Drano. Mommy, what are whores? Mommy, what's sex? Mommy, what are boobies? Mommy, what does naked mean?" You know, eventually they're gonna find the real song, and they're gonna have questions. You're gonna have to sit them down and tell them about the birds and the bees. Way to go, Kidz Bop! Fucking A plus. You tried right there. And that's really all I gotta say. So on behalf of everybody I know and myself, I want to wish all you guys Happy New Year, and let's hope nobody fucking dies this time. Over and out.